the house of God.
For your own soul's sake.
See, that's why the Bible is redundant. The Lord says things over and over because we are stiff-necked, hard-headed people.
Read that. We can't together our people. We can't together the Lord's sheep in the house of Israel.
Calm down and listen to one another. And more importantly, listen to this Bible. Right?
That's right.
Okay, watch this.
But in this last day, the Most High is raising up the true prophets of God.
Chapter 32, verse 9. Great men are not always wise.
Meaning great men in age are not always wise. Read.
Neither do the aged understand judgment.
Right. So it's talking about our aged men, our community. They don't understand the judgment of the Bible. That's why we come out here to teach it. Read.
Verse 10. Therefore I said, hearken to me. I also will show you my opinion.
Right. So we got to hearken to God. That's what we out here to do, my brother. Have you been out here before listening to us? A little bit. So what you think about what you heard so far, my brother? Do you see anything of any value that we have brought out? Have we made anything in the Bible clear to you? You got any questions about the Bible? Feel free to ask, bro. You ain't got no questions? Did you grow up in a church? You ain't go to church? Right, I understand. That's all of us to say that. But the things in the church, you ain't got no questions what you was told in church? Right, so give me one example. So this is to edify the people. We're not putting you on the spot because what you might ask, somebody else listening might have the same thing.
Right.
Like our brother here, he asked a whole bunch of questions, which is good because we know a lot of people, we all thinking the same thing. Okay. Now, are you gonna make any changes based on what you hear? Are you dealing with a sister right now? Right, see, these are the things that we got to change.
So, Rock, chapter 6 and verse 7. If thou wouldest get a friend, prove him first.
So, one thing that we don't do in our community, we don't prove one another to see where their mind is. We'll jump right into a situation. Now, you got a baby with the sister, and this sister could be evil as hell. Or vice versa, the brother could be evil as hell. See, the laws of God really keep us from harming ourselves. Like, you got children? Think about it. Did you just let your child as a baby do what he want? He's sticking a fork in the receptacle at the house. You just go ahead and let him do it? Why? Because you knew what was what in the child's best interest, correct? Just like God knows what's in our best interest, but because we are adults, we think we got a rational mind. We do what we want to do. Read Sirach 3, man. Watch this. Because as you give your children instructions to what? Keep them what? Keep them safe. Watch this.
So Rock chapter 3 and verse 1. Hear me your father, O children.
This is talking about the children of Israel and what?
And do thereafter, that ye may be safe.
Hold, what? Read that again.
So Rock 3 and verse 1. Hear me your father, O children, and do thereafter, that ye may be safe.
We all want safety. That's why we got to do what the Lord tells us to do. Read.
For the Lord hath given the father honor over the children, and hath confirmed the authority of the mother over the sons.
Right. So as you got to obey the heavenly father, your children are supposed to obey you.
Right.
For what? For all our safety. The laws of God keep us safe from ourselves and one another. That's why we out here, because we understand what's going on in our communities. We from here. We understand what's going on. That's why we come out here committed every week. We come give out flyers. We even sweep up the streets every now and then. Physically go do a cleaning of the streets. But guess what? What do our people do right after we leave? Guess what they do? Trash it back. Because the whole point is, go back to that Psalms 19:7, man. Yeah, what's your question? Good, good, good.
So my question to you is, what do you think makes some people like that? Do you think that people are doing ignorant?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
You don't think that's going on with that?
Right.
You think that nothing else making them ignorant? You think it's just ignorant?
Right. Let's get Hosea 4:6 again. Because it's not about, the thing is, it's not so much what I think.
No, right.
So we're going to show you what it is.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge.
So we rejected the laws of God. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
So we are rejected people from our Father. So we carry ourselves in a rejected manner.
In other words,
by who?
I'm not saying by who.
Right, so give me Deuteronomy 28. Read verse 1, then jump to 15. Watch this. So everything that we see in our community is a result of our evil. Like, all, then after that, what's the one in Isaiah putting away the pointing of the finger?
58:9.
Yeah, give me Isaiah 58:9. Because what we got to first do, in order to be men and women, we got to take the responsibility for all the wrong and evil in our community. Because without it, if we leave it up to an outside force, or say we just say, well, that guy is evil, I'm fine. Where's the change prompted in me? You understand what I'm saying? But if I say, you know what, I'm evil as hell, I need to do my part to clean up the community. That approach makes us all responsible and liable for the foolishness in our community. Read that.
Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 9. Then shalt thou call, and the Lord shall answer. Thou shalt cry, and he will say, here I am. If thou take away from the midst of thee the yoke, the putting forth of the finger.
You said, so the yoke is the sin. So God, if we cry, he's going to hear, and we put away the yoke, meaning our sin, and the doing what with the finger?
The putting forth of the finger.
It's his fault. It's her fault. Baby.
And speaking vanity.
Right, because those things are vain, lying words. No, it's my fault that the community is like that.
I'm the fifth. You talk about God and all the people. There got to be something opposite of God.
Right.
People like, I don't know, talk about devil, demon, spirit.
Right.
So you don't think those things are negative, but the things.
No, absolutely not. Because who controls the evil? Give me that. We got you, brother. You asked some great questions, brother. Watch this.
Isaiah chapter 45 and verse 7. Verse 7. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil.
What?
I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things.
The Lord does all that, brother. He make peace. Matter of fact, where's the one that in Sirach? That there are spirits created for vengeance. 38 or 39? Watch this. The Lord, just like, think about it for an example. When you look at, are you familiar with construction? Yeah, building. So you got certain tools that you use to build a building. Then you got certain tools you use to demolition the building. You will call the tools that you use to build good, and the demo tools will be evil. Watch this. Read that.
Sirach chapter 39, verse 28. There be spirits that are created for vengeance.
What?
There be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes.
So God sent down evil spirits, and in their fury, they lay on sore strokes. One of the sore strokes was slavery via cargo slave ships. We just had a brother suffered from the very fury of a sore stroke yesterday, where he got put to death. Read.
Which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them.
You see that? That appeases the wrath of God that made him. So when he gets sick and tired, he's going to send the evil angel down. That evil angel is going to carry out the fury of the Lord. Read.
Fire and hell and famine and death. All these were created for vengeance.
You see that? Dope. Fire is a spirit. All these things that we see, those are spirits of God. He manifests them things physically as far as the fire and the hell and things like that. But it's always angels out there activating all that. The Lord has, you know, he's the big shot. He's the boss. So he just does the finger pointing. They do the executing, so you understand. And it's going to tell you that. Read.
Teeth of wild beasts and scorpions, serpents, and the sword, punishing the wicked.
And the sword. The modern sword is what? What is the modern day sword today? The gun. It said the sword. Read.
Punishing the wicked.
Doing what?
Punishing the wicked to destruction.
We don't like to really read that part of the Bible. We don't like to read that part. You see a brother made a known drug dealer or something like that. And then that sword that was created, the lay on the sword stroke come. This is the part of the Bible that a lot of people don't like to chew the cud on. Read.
Therefore, from the beginning, excuse me, verse 31, they shall rejoice in his commandment.
You see that? Them spirits rejoice in the Lord's commandments. They not out there murmuring and doing all that. Damn, why I got to do that, man? It's my off day. Read.
And they shall be ready upon earth.
What? Where?
And they shall be ready upon earth.
They always on time. Read.
When need is, and when their time is come, they shall not transgress his word.
So when those spirits come down, like you see a brother get hit by a car, that was already orchestrated. That was that sore stroke that would be laid upon that brother or sister. Understand that. So these are the things in the Bible that we don't understand, because the misconception is that Satan is out here doing his own thing and doing all that. I'm just saying that's the Christianity, right?
Right.
They say the devil is doing this. The devil is the so-called white man. Devil just means deceiver.
Right.
He got us deceived thinking we African-American. I'm going to give you something real quick. Give me 1 Corinthians 11:3. Watch this. Because at the end of the day, this thing is going, it's like a movie. It's got the good guys versus the bad guys. The question is that all of us got to answer, what side of the fence are we going to be on?
Right.
You. It's no in between but Christ. Christ said he would have either hot or cold, meaning righteous or wicked.
Right.
You standing in between, he said he's going to spew you out of his mouth. Read that.
1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 3. But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head.
So your head is Christ. So that's why you look at all the brothers here. We got our hats off because of, as the gospel is, because you didn't know that, as the gospel is coming out to show our respect for Christ, our Savior, we take our hats off. So the question is, do you respect the black Messiah enough to remove your hat as the scriptures is coming out? Because Christ isn't this guy right here. This is a lot of times we got this guy set up in our head, this guy right here. So we don't want to bow down there, but Christ is a dark-skinned, austere man with a big white beard.
That's right.
We got a counselor, his beard was down to his chest. So so the question is, do you respect your general? Because that's the general of the army of Israel.
Right.
Understand that. We see that in the military. The captain come through and all that, the hats is all people to salute.
Right.
You don't think that's going to be the same thing with Christ? Because here's the thing. Give me that in Luke. Those that don't obey me, bring them hither. Because what's going to happen is either hats are going to be removed voluntarily or involuntarily. But the involuntary way, the hat is coming off with the head. Read that.
Luke chapter 19 verse 27. But those mine enemies, which would not that I should reign over them.
Because a lot of our people are unfortunately going to want the white man, Joe Biden and company, to rule over them.
Right.
Read. Not the black Messiah. Read.
But those mine enemies, which would not that I should reign over them, bring hither and slay them before me.
You heard what Christ said? So that's how the army of the Lord is going to be getting down. Give me Exodus 15:3. Give me Exodus 15:3. So this is the question that we pose to our brothers, is that out of respect for Christ, we make sure we have our heads uncovered as the word is coming out. Read that.
Exodus chapter 15, verse 3. The Lord is a man of war.
What?
The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name.
Right. So now, that's why we went and pulled that out, to show you that Christ is going to be the general. Always was. He's the commander of the army.
We used to scream black power while Haram was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.